Hello, beautiful ladies, and welcome to today's episode of The Scoop. For those of you who are new here, The Scoop is our chance to have a girl chat, grab some coffee, I've got some seltzer because it's the middle of the day, and we're just gonna hang out, go over our week, and just see how everybody's doing, which I really enjoy. It's a way for me to catch up with you guys and just see what everyone's been up to. So let's get into today's video. So first of all, let's get something out of the way. I'm gonna talk about this every year when this time starts to roll around. I already know it's not fall yet. Every year, I think I have a video last year where I did the same thing. I get so frustrated because they start saying that it is fall at the beginning of August. Now I know it's not the beginning of August anymore, but we still have a month left of summer and everyone keeps saying, fall is coming, fall is here. You walk into your grocery store and you are gonna see fall themed foods and pumpkins, and Halloween is not even close. And it drives me crazy. Now let me quickly say that I do really like fall. I really like the first few weeks of fall, especially as the leaves start changing when it's not too cold out, but we can start to pull out our sweaters and our cute and comfy clothes. I really do like that part of fall, and it is really fun, and I love Thanksgiving, and there's a bunch of Jewish holidays in the fall, so I love that too, because it's usually a chance for family to see each other. But I love summer so much and I wait for it all year, and to let it go early, are you crazy? Me personally, that's how I feel, because I love summertime. It feels like summer vacation, even though it's not. We still are working, of course, but we get to go to the pool, and you guys know how I feel about summer. So saying that fall is coming before fall is here is like a big no from me. And so I've just sort of accepted that this is gonna be a running joke on my channel, that I am not ready for fall to come when fall starts to make its way into our lives. No, we're not doing that on my channel. This is all gonna stay very summery and springy, meaning my background, for as long as possible. I am debating whether or not I wanna change up my background a little bit based on the seasons, maybe get something that's like a little bit more fallish for over here, and maybe get something that's a little bit fallish for over there. Let me know in the comments if you guys like that idea, if I just kind of change up my background seasonally, and I'll probably get things that are more like permanent background fixtures where, okay, every single year I bring out these certain decorations, because obviously I don't want to spend a ton on my background every single year. So just getting something that I can put out and kind of signify the change of seasons. Let me know if that's something you guys would like to see, just to have a little bit of variety in my videos. But I am curious to hear your guys' thoughts. And let me know, are you looking forward to fall? Are you ready? Are you a pumpkin spice latte kind of girl? Let me know, because a lot of people have strong feelings about it. And especially if you're someone who lives in a really, really hot area and you don't like the heat, I understand. I do understand that, okay, fall is coming, you're excited about that, you don't have to be sweating every day. But I will be happily sitting over here pretending that it's summer forever. But it is interesting to me that we as people don't like anything to be the same for too long. We do like change. I know that when the day does come that fall is here, I actually look forward to that, because it's, oh, it's a difference, it's a change. And then when I think about it moving into winter, oh, it's a difference, it's a change. And then when I think about spring and summer, it's funny how we're kind of built for that. We're built for change, we're built for cycles. We like when things kind of move in a direction, and it's definitely part of life. So I do enjoy fall when it comes. I'm just not ready for it yet. So next up, I wanted to talk a little bit about some YouTubers that I've been watching. So I have recently been watching a lot of Jessica Braun's channel. I really, really like her. I like what she talks about, and I enjoy her content quite a bit. She's very open. She seems like somebody who could be your friend. She has a little daughter and she's adorable, and she's just very down to earth. She's talking about being at home and working and making videos, but also she talks a lot about beauty and skincare and hair stuff, and I really do enjoy her content. It's very relaxing for me, and it's just stuff that I can kind of have on while I'm doing my makeup or cleaning the house or washing the dishes. And I just like her whole vibe. It's very laid back. I also really enjoy Leanne Says' channel. I really like her content. It's very friendly and relatable. She and her husband have been married around the same amount of time that Jacob and I have been married, so it's fun to kind of follow them. And they've been going on an IVF journey, which she's been very open about and sharing with her followers, which is really wonderful for us to see. And it's been, for them, a struggle, but they're working through it. And it's really a very nice thing that she's been so open about what she's been going through, because I know this is something that so many women struggle with. So it's nice to see somebody out there who's really talking about it. And then she also does declutters and fashion hauls and beauty stuff. And I just really like her channel too, because it is very relatable. And her vlogs are my favorite vlogs on the internet. I don't watch vlogs very often, but her vlogs I really enjoy, because it's just her spending time with her husband. And they're in Texas, and they like to go out. Obviously not right now. They don't really do that during the pandemic. But before the pandemic, they were touring around a bit. And it was interesting to see kind of the area and see all the different places they would visit. And that's really fun to watch too. So I really enjoy her channel, and I will link it down below along with Jessica Bronze. And then on an entirely different note, I really like allears.net. If you are somebody who is trying to plan a trip to Disney World, obviously probably not really doing that right now, but maybe you are, or if you're somebody who's just interested in Disney World or likes Disney World a lot, they have a woman named Molly who they call their correspondent, and she goes to Disney World really often, also Universal Studios out there, and she does all these different challenges and tries to show you how you can have the best time while you're there. And it's just enjoyable to follow someone around in Disney World. Since we can't go, she can go for us, and we can kind of live vicariously through her. So I've really enjoyed their videos quite a bit. Now, on a political note, I do want to mention Louder with Crowder. Now, I know his channel is a little bit controversial, but I do want to point out just a couple of his videos that I think are really, really great. His Change My Mind videos are really, really well done, because he does try to encourage good conversation, and especially his pro-life videos. His pro-life videos are really, really interesting, because you can see the other side and you can see how he responds, and it can teach you how to respond to concerns from the other side. So I really enjoy watching those. I find them very educational, especially, like I said, the pro-life Change My Minds. If you're looking for a way to educate yourself on how to have a discussion with someone who's on the other side of the argument, that's one of the places that I would start, because he really does show you, okay, somebody says this, I can respond by pointing out this, and it makes you feel a little bit more comfortable if you are in a conversation with someone about being pro-life or them being pro-choice. So let me know in the comments down below some of your favorite YouTubers to watch. I love getting recommendations from you guys and hearing what you've been watching. I want to see what you guys like. So please let me know in the comments who you've been watching and what you've been enjoying. Next up, I want to talk about something that I learned this week and something that I'm trying to incorporate into my life a little bit. So I had a conversation with a friend of mine who is moving, and she called me in a panic. And it was very, very stressful, and I could tell that it didn't need to be that stressful. Now, I've moved a few times, so I'm not saying that moving isn't stressful. It is very stressful, but that panicky feeling of, oh my gosh, was a little bit too much. It was not warranted, and she probably could have taken a couple of deep breaths and calmed herself down. And I tried to help her do that, but I don't think she was in the mental headspace for it. And that really made me sit down and think, because I think it's really hard to be classic when you're not calm and collected. It's really hard to keep your cool and be a lady when things feel crazy and panicked and really off kilter. And so I've been trying to gather my feelings and gather my thoughts and try and be more calm so that I can differentiate between what's big stuff and what's small stuff. What's something that I really do need to get worked up about? And what's something that I can stay calm and collected about? What's something that I would actually be more effective if I were calm and collected? And I felt that I feel a lot more zen since I've thought about this, where I question myself before I go to a panic place, or I question myself before I feel frazzled, and I say, is this warranted? Is this necessary? Is it? Is it not? And if it is, okay, maybe I can start to move into the panic place. But most of the time, 95% of the time, it's not. It's actually much easier to get things done when I'm calm and collected. And I feel like I have more clarity about things. And so trying to take a deep breath when I'm starting to feel overwhelmed and say, okay, can I accomplish this realistically? And how can I accomplish this realistically? How can I take control of what I can control so that this isn't overwhelming? And all of a sudden, it's like the crazy sounds in my brain shut off, and I'm able to really get done what I need to. And that has been so refreshing and really something I value and I want to keep incorporating into my life. And I'm a huge fan of affirmations. I've talked about that on my channel before, so I've started writing some things down, like classic starts with being calm. That really helps me when I start to feel, oh my gosh, everything's out of control. No, it's not. You don't have to be out of control. You don't have to feel crazed. If you aren't crazed, then you'll actually deal with the situation better. And I'm feeling very grateful that I had this conversation with that friend so that I could learn to kind of take myself down a notch when it came to being overwhelmed and being panicked. And actually, I took advantage of this the other day. We got home, Jacob and I got home from running errands, and we were hosting some people, and I was feeling overwhelmed. And Jacob said, why don't you just take 20 minutes, go to the pool, and clear your head. Leave your phone here, just sit there, maybe bring a book or something. And that's what I did, and it was so helpful. That 20-minute interval of, okay, I'm just gonna not be on my phone, no one can reach out to me, I can just relax, really cleared my head. And I had a beautiful, wonderful evening after that. And just sometimes it takes really just shutting everything off around you and saying, okay, I need to calm down. I need to meditate, if that's what works for you. I need to pray. I need to sit in silence and maybe be around people, which was what worked for me. Being around people, but me sitting in silence was a great way for me to find that zen feeling. And it was super helpful, and I'm very, very grateful to my husband for being on board with that, for saying, it's okay, you're allowed to take a few minutes. It's a good thing, actually, for you to take a couple minutes and just refresh. And it's good for him, too, because then he doesn't have to deal with panic, Dabby. So I've been really grateful for that. Let me know how you feel about that. Do you think that classic starts with being calm? Because I think it does. I really think it does. Next up, I want to talk about a couple of movies that we've been watching. Jacob and I have gotten into having some movie nights. So we've been doing this Keanu Reeves marathon, which has been fun, and we watched Speed. Speed is such a good movie. It is so much fun. First of all, I love Sandra Bullock, and Jacob told me that Sandra Bullock in that movie reminds him of me, which was a huge compliment, because A, she's gorgeous, and B, her character is very strong, and she gets done what she needs to get done. But I love that movie. It's so much fun. It's really good action. They ramp up the tension time and time again, and it is amazing how they do it. It is such a well-done film. So if you're interested in another action movie, because that's what I've been recommending lately, then definitely check out Speed. It's really good. Next up, I want to talk about Amadeus. Who here has seen Amadeus? It is fantastic. So good, so intense. And for someone who loves music, oh my gosh, it is great. And for someone who doesn't know that much about music but could appreciate it, it's a really good place to start. That film is fantastic. The struggle between a man who was born with talent and a man who believes that he has dedicated himself to God and is angry at God for not giving him the same talent as this kind of boorish person, Mozart and Salieri. Now, much of this is not accurate, and much of it is not historically accurate. Some of it is, though, and it is just a good place to start when you are learning about music. When you want to learn more about Mozart's music, you're just introduced to it in a natural way in the film, and it's so well done, because that is an incredibly intense conflict. The feeling of, why didn't God give me the talent that I so pine for, and being able to see it in another person who is not godly. How do you reconcile that? And it's just fascinating. The acting is amazing. The production values are incredible. The music, of course, it's Mozart, so it's amazing. And it holds up. I mean, it was made in the 80s, and it is still incredibly well done. Like, incredible. All of the performances are awesome. And the movie itself is dealing with these really big themes. I don't know that it finds a resolution, but it is a really incredible, incredible script, story. Everything in that movie I just love. And there's a scene specifically near the end where you see Mozart writing his Requiem. Oh my gosh. I don't know if it's because I know a little bit about music composition and I know about classical music, or if anyone would feel this way, but watching it gave me chills. And I've seen this movie before, so Jacob hadn't seen it. I wanted him to see it, so that's why we rewatched it, and it is so well done. So, if you're looking for a long but very good movie, Amadeus. Let me know in the comments if you've seen it, because I don't know how many people of our generation have, but it is very, very good. Of course, any movie that I recommend on my channel, please check for yourself if there's anything in it that you would find inappropriate. Of course, a lot of the things I'm recommending are not for children, so don't show it to your kids. But most movies, unless they're PG, are gonna have some level of either violence or sexuality, so just always be careful when you're watching those movies and do your research beforehand if that's not something you're comfortable with. But really good movies and worth watching. Totally different, but very, very good. And that's everything for this week's episode of The Scoop. I had a really good time catching up with you guys this week. I really look forward to recording The Scoop each week because it's just a way for us to chill out and relax. And I really like that. It's a fun way for us to connect. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. Please subscribe to my channel and blog if you haven't already. Head over to my Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook and follow me there. Hit that notification bell to get notified of all my new videos. Hit that like button. Please head over to classicallyabby.locals.com if you'd like to support my channel, see more of this content, and be part of our community. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!